Did you know that you can get Social Security spousal or survivor benefits from an ex-spouse? Stay tuned and I'll give you all the details about how to do it. It's well documented that divorce will often have a financial impact on both parties. One thing that it doesn't have to impact is your ability to get a spousal or survivor benefit based on your ex-spouse's work history. All you have to do is meet the qualifications. And there are two main rules that govern this. The first rule is that the marriage must have lasted for at least 10 consecutive years. And then you must be at least age 62 or 60 if the ex-spouse is deceased. Now those are the basic rules, but as you may have suspected, it doesn't end there. For this video to make the most sense, we need to break it down into two separate categories. And the first is if your spouse is still alive, and then we'll look to see if your spouse is deceased. This is important because if your ex-spouse is still alive, you could qualify for a spousal benefit. But if your ex-spouse is deceased, you could qualify for a survivor benefit. So first, let's take if your spouse is still alive. If you meet the length of marriage rules, you are eligible for the greater of your own benefit or up to one half of your ex-spouse's full retirement age benefit. Very important note here for a spousal benefit from an ex-spouse. Remarriage, that is if you get remarried, that will stop the spousal benefit from the ex-spouse. So I want to walk through an example of how these spousal benefits work, but first, I have to give you a bit of a warning here. There's some charts ahead where the numbers can seem pretty small. So if you're on a mobile device, you may want to come back and watch this video on your desktop. Go ahead and try it on your mobile device, but if you can't make it out, you can see these numbers on a desktop. So in this chart, I first want to look at your ex-spouse's full retirement age benefit amount. And then I want to look at your age because that's how the benefit amount is going to be determined. And I want to look at what percentage of your ex-spouse's full retirement age benefit you'll receive. And that gives us your spousal benefit amount from that ex-spouse. So first, let's take your full retirement age of 67. Now we're using 67 because for anyone born 1960 or later, that is the full retirement age. But if you were born before 1960, your full retirement age is something less than age 60. And I've put some details in the bottom of this chart for you to get in there and tell. Also, I have another video on my website that talks about how to calculate when your full retirement age is. But again, if you're born in 1960 or later, your full retirement age is 67. And that's the number we're going to use for purposes of keeping all of this easy to understand. So if your ex-spouse's full retirement age benefit is $2,000, you are full retirement age, or 67, you are entitled to receive 50% of your ex-spouse's full retirement age benefit. And that gives you a spousal benefit amount of $1,000. If you file earlier than full retirement age, the amount that you receive begins to decrease. So at 66, you would only receive 45.83%, or $917. And that amount continues to go down all the way until the earliest age of eligibility, which is age 62, at which point you would receive 32.5% of the full retirement age benefit of your ex-spouse. So if your ex-spouse has a full retirement age benefit of $2,000, but you file for that benefit at 62, you're going to receive around $650. Now, I want to put a hard stop right here at full retirement age. The reason for that is that if a spousal benefit is the highest benefit that you will ever be entitled to, there's no good reason to delay filing beyond your full retirement age. Because look what happens to the numbers as we move out. They don't change. There are no delayed retirement credits for spousal or survivor benefits. So once you hit full retirement age, it doesn't change except for the little bit of cost of living adjustments that you would get anyway. So before we move on to survivor benefits from an ex-spouse, I want to cover something that causes some confusion. For a married couple, the higher earning spouse has to file before the other spouse can receive a spousal benefit. That does not apply in a divorce case. The only rule is the divorce must have been final for at least 2 years before you can claim a benefit on your ex-spouse's history. And something else to know, you filing for a spousal or survivor benefit on your ex-spouse's work record is not going to decrease benefits to him or his current spouse or anyone else in his family. In fact, he or she will never even know. So those are the spousal benefits that's available to you if your ex-spouse is still alive. So now let's go into if your ex-spouse is deceased. The rules do change some for these survivor benefits from an ex-spouse. First of all, you can file for a survivor benefit as early as age 60 instead of the 62 for a spousal benefit. Now, I want to make a note here for the survivor benefit and the spousal benefit, the earnings limit does apply, which means that there is a certain amount of earnings that you can have and draw benefits before the Social Security Administration will start to cut those benefits off. There's a video on my website, Working in Social Security. You need to check that out to fully understand the way these income limits work. Those do go away at your full retirement age, so they only apply at full retirement age and under. One of the other big differences with survivor benefits is that remarriage at 60 or later does not make you ineligible for a survivor benefit. So if you are 60 or older, drawing a survivor benefit from a prior spouse, and then you get remarried, if that survivor benefit is higher than the spousal benefit that you could get from your new spouse, you can continue to draw that survivor benefit. And then one of the important things is that you can switch between your own benefit and survivor's benefits. Now, the switching strategy is very important, and I want to spend just a minute talking about this because, again, there's a lot of miscommunication and misinformation out there about this. The Omnibus Reconciliation Act of 2015 was the budget that was passed, and in that, it killed almost all of the switching strategies within Social Security. However, it preserved one type of benefit that you could still switch to, and that's a survivor benefit. So let me give you an example real quick of how this would work. It's very important to understand this. So let's assume that your benefit is $1,500 per month at full retirement age. Your deceased ex-spouse has a full retirement age benefit of $1,750. Now, knowing what you know about survivor benefits, you know that at full retirement age, you would be entitled to $1,750 or the $1,500. But could it make sense to file early for a survivor benefit and then later switch back to your own benefit? So let's assume that you're 62 and you're ready to file for benefits now. You're no longer working and you need this income coming in. If you file for your own benefit, you're going to receive around $1,050. However, there's that survivor benefit available of $1,394 after it's been reduced for filing age. So let's walk through this and see how this switching strategy may work. So let's say that Karen is 62. Her survivor benefit is $1,394, and that's what she files for. And she collects that survivor benefit all the way up until her 70th birthday. And then at age 70, Karen would simply go into the Social Security Administration's office and turn on her own benefit, which has now grown substantially with the delayed retirement credits. Again, this is something that's only available within survivor benefits. And it doesn't make sense for everyone, but for those that it does work for, it can be a huge asset. So there's a couple of other questions that I often receive. And one is, what about Medicare? Do I get Medicare based on my ex-spouse's work record? And the answer is yes. So long as you were married 10 years and they qualified for Medicare, you also will qualify for Medicare. Another question that I often hear is, so what if I've been married more than once? Well, if all marriages have ended and you are currently single or you meet one of the other exclusions, you can pick and choose from the highest benefit that's available to you. So if you have one spouse who is not deceased but another spouse who is, then you can get the survivor benefit. And then if the other spouse passes away, if that survivor benefit is higher, you can go back and get that survivor benefit. But some of that is going to take some proactive behavior on your part. The Social Security Administration isn't necessarily going to keep up with all of your beneficiaries and come tell you when you should be receiving a higher benefit. So I hope this review of Social Security and divorce helps you and makes it possible for you to go out and maximize your benefits and have the best retirement you possibly can. Before you leave, I'd like to ask you to do me a quick favor. First, please subscribe to this channel. We've been so fortunate to hit this many subscribers this early on, and we want to keep this momentum going. Second, go out to Amazon and find my book, Social Security Basics. It's a short read, and it's just that. It's a basic look at what you need to know to be able to navigate Social Security. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a fantastic day.